Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Drive Life. This time in a 1995 Mazda Miata. This one is really tricked out, though, and it's a little different because I actually own a Miata now. So for any of you who do not follow me on Instagram, which I highly suggest you go do, which is polcat34.official, I recently bought a Miata, and it's going to be very interesting to go ahead and now drive one of these in a game when I drive it in real life. So let's go ahead. We're just going to go ahead and get this started. It's a 1995, so this is the same year that Bugs has. Mine is a 1991. Zach has a 1996. So a little bit of different ranges in Crown Vics. And then Zach, I believe, has like a 99 Crown Victoria. 99 or like 2000, not exactly sure. And then I have a 07 and an 06, and Bugs has an 08. So we have quite the selection of vehicles, I guess you could say. But other than that, we are here in the Mazda. This one is fucking pretty crazy, I gotta admit. This one just has a shit ton of stuff. We're gonna go ahead and make sure we pump this engine. I wanna make sure I have brakes too, or else we're not gonna be able to get anywhere. Oh, I don't wanna get hit. So we have it white. I just primered my whole car white. We're gonna get ready to rattle can it with a nice gloss coat. If you do it right, you can make rattle can paint look very good. It won't last really long, but for a temporary solution, it does look pretty good. So we're going to go ahead and get this started. I'm just going to go ahead and rip it. So these cars are known for, if you've never driven a Miata, which that's awesome that you get to see other Miatas on the road like that. If you've never driven a Miata, it's like driving what in Bugs' terms, a street legal go-kart. And when I drive it, that is very much so what it feels like. You can take corners so quick, you can take corners very tight, and it just gives you, it's like you're at Boomers, or if you guys have that, it's like, you know, the arcade with go-karts, or Camelot if you're old school with it, but it's like you're at the go-kart track and you're able to turn it really quick and tight, but you're on the open road, and it's just definitely an experience that is like no other driving experience, especially if you drive a Crown Vic, and I like daily to Crown Vic. And now getting in a Miata, it's nice having two vehicles to have two completely different driving styles in. It's as simple as that. And this thing is just amazing in this game. I can guarantee you right now I'm going to leave this in my game because I absolutely love this car. It looks badass too. I wouldn't do all the crazy riding unless it was riding that meant something to me. But other than that, this thing is fucking amazing. It's an add-on to replace. The add-on wasn't working for me, unfortunately, so I had to put it in as a replace. But other than that, even though it's a replace, it still seems to work really good. The tires go through the wheel wells a little, but this thing slammed beyond belief. So, and the stance, I want to get some type of stance like this. I don't know if I want it to be too crazy, but maybe something a little, once I get the engine and all that, really worked down and dialed down. I'm going to go ahead and jump on the freeway. This thing is spider-like, though. When Bugs passes me and he's in his Miata, it almost gives me a spider-like feeling, like it's a spider crawling throughout the ground, except it's a vehicle. That's why I want to get mine lowered in time. Once I get, I don't know, maybe these rims would work and I could just get it lowered. It's not, these rims I have on it were plasti-dipped, and they weren't that bad of rims, but they plasti-dipped them and they made them look fucking fake as shit. So it's like, why are you going to plasti-dip rims when it just totally decreases the value of them? I mean, if you really want to, spray paint them. And that's what we did. We spray painted them black, and man, they literally look like brand new rims. The plasti-dip helped save the metal underneath. They were chrome rims, and they were like solid. I can't remember what name they are, but they were solid as hell. And there were no scratches, dings, or anything. Just the plasti-dip took all the life out of them. And they had to have been purchased, you know, not that long ago and plasti-dipped, which is just, it's weird to me that someone would take something nice-looking and plasti-dip it. If you have anything, you know, at least paint it. I've had my fair share of plasti-dip experience, and I fucking hate plasti-dip. I cannot stand it. It is the worst. Anyone that's worked with it, you know why. This car is very easy to get in and around traffic because of how small it is. I haven't yet to hit anything. We've kind of just been speeding in and out. This is why I love it, though. You see a gap? Oh, shit. You can most likely get in it. Get in it. Shit, English is not doing too well. It's pretty late right now. But this is a very beautiful car, even in this game. I don't know. I wasn't into Miatas. I wasn't into small little, you know, race cars like this. But after driving it and figuring out the customization you can do to it, it completely changes my aspect on this car. It's a fun little car to take out on the road. You know, get some good tires and make sure that, you know, you don't go careening off the road, but go to a curvy road and this thing is the perfect vehicle for it. You cannot ask for any other type of vehicle, except for maybe, you know, other sports cars or something that are so small like this. But damn scripted vehicles, and they're probably going to get in the left-hand turn lane. Who fucking leaves their driveway and immediately goes in the left-hand turn lane? Come on, motherfucker. But yeah, so we're going to go ahead, and I'm going to actually take this up into the really windy hills. Up or down, I have a feeling this car is going to be absolutely amazing on handling. Just because it's in the Banshee slot. God, I don't know if I said that right. Oh, that corner always gets me. Once you launch, you have no traction, and yeah, you can't turn. So, it's in the Banshee slot. I feel like I'm not saying that right. But yeah, it's in the Banshee slot, and unfortunately, when you replace it, you have to just put it over that slot, and you don't get any custom handling. I'm not sure if he even did that in the first place. He could have just extracted, the Banshee handling and, you know, just used that standard, which, if that's the case, it seems to work very well. I gotta give it a solid, 6 out of 10 for the handling just to throw over another vehicle for GTA. Seems to work pretty well. The only thing that I do not like is the turning radius. Like, watch here. We're going to go ahead and... Oh, my God. I did not hit that gap at all. I'm going to see if I can try to find a tight turn and show you guys that the turning radius should be pretty fucking tight on this thing. I can just go around a pole and barely hit it and just keep turning the tightest circles with how crazy the turning radius is. It's crazy, and I love it. Oh, who slapped? Seems legit. Underneath. That's how low we are right now. So low we went underneath this trailer. All right, let's go ahead and see. Well, the Banshee does have good handling, but we need a really tight turn like we're going out of a stop sign or something, because Miatas can really hit it. God, this car is good. If it doesn't lose its traction, it can really handle pretty damn well. I'm going to go ahead and see if I could drift a little with other cars. Oh, man, that was a good one. That was a fucking good one right there. Holy shit, rate that one. That was the first drift in this video that I could say, hey, rate this. Ooh, don't hit them. Oh, my God, that could have been really bad. But the luck and spider-like of this vehicle got us through it, ladies and gentlemen. Holy shit. So, coming up on about 10 minutes, 2 minutes away from that, so we're going to go ahead and get the cops on us. This usually is where it happens down here. I'm just going to... Oh, my God, that was pretty cool. All right, we're going to go ahead and fix the vehicle up. So, Simeon, thank you for doing that so quick. I appreciate it. And go ahead and get some cops on us. I'm going to make sure I don't have any never wanted on. Seems like we're good on that part. Pull out a weapon and start killing people. I don't know how long it'll take for cops to get here, but if it doesn't work pretty soon, within like the next 10 seconds, I'll go ahead and speed the process along. Looks like I actually have to kill someone, which is kind of sad. And that didn't take long. Where are they? Coming in behind us. All right, forward first. So we're probably going to have the Canadian cars still in. That's actually the last thing I had in. So we're going to be chased by Canadian police right now, which is actually going to be pretty interesting. Looks like we're going to have Canadian police and some type of black and white. Uh-oh, don't shoot. Don't shoot. Okay, I don't know what type of vehicle that is. I'm going to turn around and see if it's maybe LAPD. I have no idea. I think it might be. Oh, no, that's the traffic unit that they have. I don't understand the whole black and white without any oh, there it is. That's the one with texture on it. Maybe they do have one without texture. That would be very strange. But that's one of the upcoming vehicles in the Canada pack we're going to be using, or Canada Week, I guess you could say. What was that guy doing on the side of the road? Holy shit, I have no idea. He looked like he had a gun to his head. All right, they're on my ass right now. These guys are relentless. But so far, we're able to kind of get a gap whenever we really need to in this car. That's how simple it is. I'm going to slow down and let him catch up a little. Oh, please don't hit anything, guys. I like that front light in the front. I'm going to see where in the hell it's located. Oh, no. Winnebago. Holy shit. Okay. They have ridiculous... Oh, that's a sick white. Hold on. That's really cool. I want to see what the hell texture that is. Oh, I have no idea. I cannot look right now. It's not working out for me. Okay, we're getting out of here. That might have been the texture I actually used in the first episode of Canada Week, but I'm not exactly sure. I got to get a distance because these motherfuckers, they have, like, super-powered Crown Vicks. That's a nice light in the front. Come on. Uh-oh. Go! No. I will not die right here. Come on, you far. He moved. Holy shit, we almost died because that guy trapped us in that bitch. Fuck you, dude. It's your fault that I got trapped in that shit. Alright, there's a ton of cops now. Our wanted level has really gone up. I do not have bulletproof tires, so I gotta make sure I do not hit any spike strips. Or else that's definitely gonna ruin this streak I got going on. Alright, so... I'm gonna try to lose them in the Sandy Shores area. I might be able to do this. This should be easy in this type of car. They haven't got a tire yet. I don't have bulletproof tires, so I gotta watch myself. Is this a roadblock, or is this just a still cop? Come on, motherfucker, what's up? Into the pole. You piece of shit. Oh, I like that traffic advisor in the back. That's awesome. Oh, they're all decked out. This is so cool. I'm actually going to really enjoy using these vehicles when they, I didn't know they had texture work on the side. I thought it was just black and white without any, markings, which I thought would have been a little strange, to be honest. But, you know, every department, every place has their own different techniques and, style, I guess you could say. Going to go this way. Not going to work. Come on, motherfucker. Get me out of this. At least I haven't hit any roadblocks. If I get some roadblocks, we're going to be kind of fucked because if... it's as simple as a tilt. I have no idea what I just said there, but that was a roadblock. They most likely had, Oh, dead doggy. Fuck, I don't get why they do that. Come on, guys. Don't just go on oncoming... Oh, no. Mailbox. Fuck. So one thing about this car that I want to get with mine that I don't have is the low-profile lights. Those are really awesome, and I fucking love them. The ones on the Miata are just way too fucking big. They're ridiculous. So that's one of the things I want to get. But let's see if we can lose these guys. We have a fucking helicopter joined in now. Okay, he just hit a pole, so I'm going to go ahead and use this time to get the hell away from him. Okay, roadblock. I got to get away from the helicopter. Do not hit that. Fuck, you hit it. Wow, that thing is fucking... ton of polys, it looks like. God damn. Alright, coming straight at a unit. Helicopter is in the area, but I think I'll be able to escape from him. Just don't want to hit this fucking boat on a trailer. Boat on a trailer again! So many boats on a trailer, and this is a spike strip guy, and that was a fucking cop! I had no idea. Holy shit, I didn't even recognize that was a black and white. I feel pretty bad right now that I did not do that. Okay, we got to get in an area where I can lose them, so... Oh my gosh. That could have been really bad. Alright, all white unit right here. I hate how they steer in the front. It's like, you really think you're gonna be that good? Here we go. Come on. Oh! Shit, that was close. Ooh, here we go. No! That was close. We were doing the back and forth chicken thing. These guys are fucking assholes. Come on. Oh! God, at least this thing can handle in the dirt a little. That's always a plus. Alright, we gotta keep avoiding the roadblocks. God damn it, don't hit them. There we go. Biker game. Ooh, none of them got hit. This is getting intense as fuck. I gotta admit, this is pretty fun. It's been a while since we've had one of these nice chases like this. Oh my god, we were able to fucking lift this car up. Come on, car. Come on, no. Oh shit, okay. Hold it together. Stay on this side of the guardrail. Both of them are following you. Okay. One of them made it over. Other than that, I am doing some crazy shit. Holy shit. Get on the right side of the road. This is fucking insane. Okay, I have a good distance on the ground units. I still have a helicopter unit in my path, so I want to go ahead and see if I can shake that guy. I'm just going to go ahead and rip it down this highway. And most likely... I'll be able to get away from the helicopter. Oh my gosh. Gotta look out for the roadblocks. Gotta look out for roadblocks and still cops located on the highway like this. Oh, come on, dude! No! Thank God for the roll cage. Oh, I fucked the front of my car up. Oh, they just hit each other. Okay, we should be able to get... Oh, they're way too intelligent. I don't understand how they can do that. Come on, motherfucker! George of the Jungle! Okay, come on, flip. That pole helped me flip. Oh, I'm gonna get shot, guys. Ooh, shit, they're shooting at me from the helicopter. This is not good at all. I really gotta shake them, and I gotta shake them right now. And all of my pieces in the front end are falling off, which is not good. There's double units up here. Oh, shit, they're blocking down the whole fucking highway. They don't know how to work together, though. Oh, not again, not round two. Oh, motherfucker, dude. This is not good. Why am I having so much trouble? Okay, I'm going to go ahead and start taking side streets and alleyways and shit like that. I'm going to go ahead and get off the highway. Try to take as many turns as I can, because if I do that and if I go around as many cars, then I should have a chance of being able to get away from these guys. I'm going to flip around right here. They got units stationed pretty much everywhere. So I'm going to try to get in an area with that. I can just take a complete right turn. I want to get off the fucking highway, though. I don't know how exactly to do so. So that'll be my main objective right now, is getting off the highway, because I want to lose these guys. Here we go. Exit only. Oh, please make it. This car is not going to be able to take that much more damage. I have armor all the way up, but I have taken some pretty crazy hits. And you can hear how bad it is right now. Oh, shit. I can hear all the cops that have chased me. Oh, man. They're about to take the exit. I got to really shake it. Oh, I just passed the police station. That's going to really piss them all off. Watch out. Coming in. All right. I think I should be able to escape them here. I just got to make sure I don't go straight towards them and take roads that might not have them. And I should be able to go. Fucking helicopter. Are you kidding me right now? Come on. I'm so close. I am so close. Oh, they haven't seen me for a really long time. Shit on my face. Come on. Get into a point. All right, helicopter's going the wrong direction. I think I'm going to be able to lose them here. I got it, guys. Fuck, two units coming right at me. I don't got it. Oh, shit, I'm not going to be able to turn tight. Oh, they got me right here. Fuck. Oh, that sucks. God damn it. Oh, I hear the sirens. I got to get out of here. Shit. I'm going to just fucking hop curbs, do whatever I can to get out of the way. Oh, fuck. I was so close. Oh, that sucks. All right, I got to take alleyways and stay under, like, freeways so that way they can't fucking see me in a helicopter. I hear the sirens everywhere. Okay, I'm going to turn up left here. Hopefully he won't turn around. This car is so beat to hell. Oh, I'm passing two units right here. Son of a bitch. Oh, there's one. It's a fucking Explorer unit. Son of a bitch, man. They're getting new types of fucking police officers involved in different types of cars. This is shitty. All right, just keep it together. Oh, that's amazing. It's a marked unit, too. I didn't know there was a marked. I thought it was only a slick top. Oh, that's so cool. Okay, there's an issue here. I'm fucked. I don't know if I'm going to be able to escape these guys unless I actually hide out in an alleyway. Okay, fuck, fuck, fuck. I've been everywhere on this map, and nowhere I've gone has really taken me to a good location at this point. Here we go. Here we go. I'm going to turn around. Fuck, they're all directions. I got to hit this left. Come on. I got this. So close. They're coming at me. Oh, no, 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 no. Keep your car still. Here we go. Please don't spawn any in front. We got this. I'm going to fucking go into the fucking golf course, because if they have any in the golf course, this is some bullshit. It's a conspiracy. I got to talk to someone about this shit, because this ain't cool. Oh, man. This has been good, though. I would definitely say... Besides them, oh, fucking helicopter, they have it in the golf course. They have it in the golf course. Shit, shit, shit. Besides the fact that I just have horrible luck, even though I just lost them. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. This is a good vehicle to get away from cops. It's, you can hit tight turns, all that fun shit. And it's just a fun car to drive around. It's absolutely amazing. You can drift if you need to. Like I said, it's just, it's like a spider on the road. And that's exactly what I imagine when I see this on the road and when I just picture it and all that stuff. But... really hope you guys enjoyed this drive life, and other than that, we will see you next video.